When biologists use the term ventilation, it refers to any mechanism that works to move the medium in which an organism lives, whether that be air or water, over the gas exchange surface. A chest X-ray. Here you can see the lungs enclosed by the rib cage. In humans, the lungs are ventilated, or air is forced in and out by the action of muscles. When muscles contract, the fibers slide into each other. In the case of the human lungs, two important sets of muscles contract. One is the block of muscle beneath the rib cage, known as the diaphragm, and the other is a set of muscles that run on the outside of the ribs, the external intercostal muscles. Let's examine this with a simple model. At rest, the diaphragm is in the dome shaped, but when muscles contract, the diaphragm takes on a flattened shape. This results in an increased volume in the thoracic cavity and a decreased pressure. Also working to increase the size of the thoracic region are the external intercostal muscles. When these muscles contract or slide into each other, they pull the rib cage up and out, and in so doing, they increase the volume of the thoracic cavity. This increased volume is coupled to a decreased pressure, and the result is a flow of air in through the trachea, through the bronchi, into the bronchioles, and then into tiny air sacs known as alveoli. This type of ventilation is known as negative pressure ventilation. When it's time for expiration or to exhale air, the muscles of the diaphragm relax and return to their dome shape and force air out of the lungs. In instances of forced expiration or coughing, another muscle set which runs on the inside of the rib cage, the internal intercostal muscles, contract and force the size of the thoracic cavity to become even smaller. This is further assisted by the contraction of the abdominals to force a jet of air out of the lungs. In the osteichthyes, the bony fishes, water is taken in through the mouth. Next, the floor of the mouth is lowered to increase the volume. The mouth is then closed, and with the gill covers or the operculum also closed, the floor of the mouth is then raised. This builds up a very high pressure, a positive pressure, inside of the mouth cavity. Next, the gill covers open, and a jet of high-pressure water is sent over the gills. This is an example of positive pressure ventilation. The mouth opens to take in a large volume of water. The floor of the mouth is lowered, and with the mouth and the gill covers closed, it is then raised to build up a high pressure. When the gills are opened, a jet of high-pressure water flows over the rich blood supply. When all of the gills of the fish are removed, it is evident that not only is there a rich blood supply, but there is a huge surface area available for the exchange of gases. These characteristics of large surface area, thin membrane with very high blood supply, are key characteristics of any gas exchange surface. And the gill lamella of the bony fish is one such surface, and so are the alveoli of the mammalian lungs. These tiny air sacs are well supplied with blood and the blood runs very close to the air sacs, separated by just one cell of thickness. Within the air sacs, a huge surface area is exposed for the oxygen in the moisture-filled air to diffuse into the blood and for carbon dioxide to leave the blood. But these characteristics of large surface area are not confined to the animal kingdom. The leaf, the site of significant gas exchange in plants, possesses a very high surface area to volume ratio. In addition, the inside of the leaf contains many air spaces filled with moisture. This allows for adequate diffusion of gases into the leaf and for gases produced by the leaf to diffuse out. The earthworm provides yet another example of the characteristics of gas exchange surfaces. Confined to a life in its moisture-filled soil, the large surface area is shown by the folds in its skin, a very thin skin which allows the blood capillaries to be easily seen. Large surface area, thin, moist, and rich blood supply. Four key characteristics of the alveoli of the mammalian lungs.